on the downpipe. Ran out of welding gas, so I'm kind of stuck on that right now. I mean, welding gas, what am I thinking? Ran out of welding wire. No more. So I'm waiting on my brother to bring me some for now. In the meantime, kind of just frustrated at the same time with this. So I'm going to paint the valve cover of the sr20. I already went ahead and took off all the bolts and the coil packs. I just let them dangle right here. Disconnected the hoses, and I believe it should pop up. Oh, well, there goes that. No way. This thing might have Tomei cams. Holy crap, dude. Tomei cams in it. Holy shit. Excuse the language. Oh, there we go. There we go. Nice. Popped off actually like butter. Oh my god. Dang. Actually super, super duper clean in here. I am very surprised. Holy cow. Super clean. Look at that. Cleanest SR20 ever. Holy cow. Yeah. That's a Tomei. It might be a rocker stopper. I don't know if it's a cam, Tomei cams. But they look really clean. Holy cow, I am stoked. Oh, what the heck is that? Rubber glove inside? That's not good. Yeah, super clean. Super duper clean. I am, holy, blown out of my mind. But yeah, let's get to work. Just gonna put it on the old doing it this yellow, just because I think yellow would be a nice bright color. At the same time, if there's any leaks, you can see where they're coming from. And then afterward, I'll probably give these a lick with some sandpaper. Give them a lick. I'll give them some sanding with some sandpaper and paint them red. And I think that'll look pretty nice. And go from there. Let me go grab some masking tape. That way I can mask all this and go from there. Alright, so got them all masked off. Now it's just a matter of spraying it. So I'm probably gonna spray one coat of this 650 temperature VHT paint. Just because it's similar to the yellow, and I'll give it a little bit of a heat protection. I've been told, you know, it should be fine. I believe these ones are rated to like 200 and something degrees of temperature, 200 degrees temperature in general, and I think these get about that temperature or so. So I'm just gonna give it one coat of this VHT high temp paint, and then I'll coat it with that and go from there. So you guys will be able to see what I'm doing. really nice actual color. Holy cow. I don't know if I want to just leave it that, take the runs that I did, or paint it actually yellow. Because that's, holy cow, that's a really nice. That's, geez. Too bad it's not going to stay that glossy. Well, I could clear coat it. Yeah, I think I might do that. Gotta just fix those runs that I did, because I was kind of in a hurry. I'll fix them. Use this paintbrush that I have and just spray some in the lid here and touch it up. I pretty warmed it up, so it should be good and mixed. Messed up, but yeah, so looks pretty good. I mean, it's upside down, but yeah, the brush kind of screwed me over in some spots, but hey, it doesn't look too bad. Now I just need to do this side and then we'll be done. Done too. Looks decent. I mean, I'm not a professional. This is going into that white convertible 240. So, yeah. But this is it. I mean, turned out pretty sweet, I think. I like the color. Oh, you know what? I still need to clear it. I got some clear coat that I found. I'm gonna clear it and then I'll show you guys the finished product. All right, I put it on and I think it turned out pretty good for compared to how it was. I mean, it was basically like this manifold. I mean, this manifold, not too bad, but it's kind of crusty. And then bam, looks pretty good. I like it, you know. Might not be the best. I did get a little run over here. You can't really tell too much. But I think it looks good and it's way better than how it was. And I'm sure that it'll, you know, whoever in the future buys the car is gonna love it.